Hey guys, so in this video I want to compare the iPhone 6 a little bit here versus the Sony Xperia Z3 Compact, which I just got today, which is a pretty cool little, as you can hear in the name, Compact Xperia Z3. So let's just start here, the feel of these two devices, how they feel in the hand. This one is actually really, really, really compact compared to the bigger Xperia Z3. This one, it's a little bit thicker, as you probably can see. Let's see here if we can turn off the display. As you can see, it's a little bit thicker. It has like a plastic thing here on the sides, but still feels very, very comfortable. And also the buttons feels very, very solid. Has a dedicated camera button as well. It has also a glass back, so it still feels like a premium phone, kind of, almost. Not really that bad, actually. You can also see the camera here, 20 megapixel camera, pretty nice. You really get a beast packaged in this one here. Of course, the brand new iPhone, I really, really do enjoy this one because it really, really feels good. You can see here I have the gold edition, but I also have a silver edition. The camera sticks out a little bit, only 8 megapixel. This is the antenna thing, I think. But very, very cool piece of metal here. I really did enjoy the Apple Touch 4th generation, and they really did decide to go to more of a iPod design on their phones. So very, very nice. A better Touch ID as well, from what I've heard. Of course, iOS, which is a simple operating system, which could also be very, very nice for many people. You can also see here that it's thinner. The iPhone is definitely thinner. They have the same weight though, which is interesting. But it's pretty easy here to see which one that is thinner. Wow. Big, big major difference there. You gotta have to pay around, I think around, at least in my country, it's around 300 more bucks to get the iPhone 6 Plus compared to the Xperia Z3 Compact, so it's definitely a interesting to see if it's worth it. 4.7-inch display versus a 4.6-inch display, so a little bit bigger display here that you do get on the iPhone 6. But then also the display becomes even a little bit smaller on the Xperia Z3 Compact because the buttons are built into the display, when the iPhone used to have the button on the outside. So both are 16 gigabyte phones here. You get 2 gigabytes of RAM inside the Xperia Z3 Compact here. So use a little bit more there, but usually Android requires that. You can kind of see also here how they are a little bit the same here. Notifications, you have a today section here, of course, and widgets on the iPhone 6 that you'll be able to edit and add more stuff there. As I've been showing, some widgets you can use for your iPhones and your iOS devices. And then we do have some quick toggles here on the Xperia device, Xperia Z3 Compact. If you want them, of course, on the iPhone, you swipe from the bottom, and then you also get a little bit of a similar functions here. You do have an edit section here, though, and pretty cool. You can add more to the Xperia Z3 Compact, and that's very, very nice. Apple is trying to minimize it a little bit, and trying to just pick out the essentials or the things that people do use the most. So another thing here, as I said there, 20 megapixel camera inside of the Xperia Z3 Compact, which is very, very cool if you do care about taking great pictures. You probably will be very, very happy with the high resolution on these pictures. Of course, you have a ton of different modes here as well, and ton of things to explore. Very, very disappointing here with the iPhone, it still only has an 8 megapixel camera, even though it's not just about the megapixels. They should definitely be able to bump that up. And I think it's Sony also that's doing the camera for Apple, so that means that it probably isn't that bad, but very, very nice UI though. Definitely world-class UI here on the iPhone. and cool that you can change the exposure in iOS 8. So another little thing here, Snapdragon 801 here inside of the Z3 Compact, so it's a beast. And the Apple A8 chipset inside of the iPhone. Dual core 1.4 GHz inside of the iPhone, which flows very, very nice. And then we have a very, very nice processor also inside of our clock speed on the Xperia Z3 Compact, which is quad-core 2.5 GHz, Cortex 400, with the Adreno 330 GPU. So one of the best GPUs at the moment for Android here. So you'll be able to have a very, very nice gaming experience probably on most games, which is very, very awesome. And of course, on the iPhone, you also will be having amazing experience with games, maybe a little bit upscale because they're not that optimized at the moment for the bigger iPhones, but that definitely will be fixed probably. With the PowerVR GX6450 GPU, which is quad-core graphics, very, very nice. Battery life here, there's a difference. You do get 1810 milliamps inside of the iPhone, and then 2600 milliamps inside of the Xperia Z3 Compact. And some guys said that the battery only went down 1% when I did the Xperia Z3 versus the iPhone 6 video. It just went down 1% on the Xperia Z3, so it looks like the Sony device is having very, very good battery lives. You can see that they also have this power management app here inside of the Sony device, so you'll be able to optimize battery life so you can use the device even longer. But I'm pretty confident here that the battery is going to last longer here on the Z3 Compact. And you can see both smooth, no problems with them both. Definitely, if you want to see more videos with these two devices, definitely let me know if you want to see some specific comparisons. But remember, these are very, very high-end devices at the moment, so you probably won't have any problems, any major problems with any one of these. But yeah, quickly look here on specs and stuff. Of course, a big thing here with the Xperia Z3 Compact is the customization with Android. You'll be able to change a lot of things from the stock, but also that it's IP68 certification. So you can take this one in water and dust, and it should just be fine because it has that water resistant body, which is very, very awesome. So yeah. Quick little comparison here. Definitely let me know which one is your favorite, and if you want to see anything, any specific videos with these two devices, definitely let me know about that, and I definitely will see what I can do. Have an awesome day.